The Pumpkin Giant. Once upon a time, back when the very fairy tales that we speak of existed in the world amongst us, was the kingdom of Colossia. To the east of the kingdom lived the Pumpkin Giant. The Pumpkin Giant was the biggest and most notorious gargantuan that had ever existed. Now, the people did not know how many fruits and vegetables and potatoes were their staple food. Though tasty, the excessive carbohydrates in potatoes and lack of exercise caused the population to become obese. This became a golden opportunity for the Pumpkin Giant, who kept watch on the kids who were affected by obesity and used to capture them and make them his servants.
Come on, get inside. You don't want the Pumpkin Giant to get you now, do you?
Coming, Papa.
This drove fear into everyone in Colossia, especially King Rainer, that had a daughter, Diana, who, like the other kids of Colossia, was obese.
The princess should always have two wizards around her, protecting her at all times, and send a message to the people that whoever will successfully defeat the Pumpkin Giant shall receive the honor of knighthood.
Yes, sir.
The princess was never allowed to leave the palace and was always tailed by two guardian wizards. Meanwhile, the message was conveyed to the people, who were driven to get knighted by the king. But no matter how eager or driven they were, they could not even hold a stick straight, just thinking about the giant. To the east of the kingdom lived a poor farmer, Patroclus, with his wife, Daphne, and their son, Aeneas. They owned a large mass of land close to the Pumpkin Giant's underground lair, where they grew potatoes. Aeneas, too, like the princess, was quite obese. The poor family spent most of their money on fulfilling his large appetite and did not have much food for themselves.
My love, what are we to do about the money?
Don't worry, my dear. I will find a way.
One day, while Patroclus and Aeneas were out in the field digging out potatoes, the earth vigorously trembled before them.
Oh my! It's the Pumpkin Giant! Run!
No, Father. I can't. I'm too exhausted.
Oh, my son! Then get behind me, quick!
Aeneas went and crouched behind his father, but it was in vain, for it was like he was hiding behind a slim pole. The earth shook with each step that the Pumpkin Giant took as he came closer and closer to the poor man and his son.
What do we do now?
Worried and scared, Patroclus looked around as the Pumpkin Giant got closer to him. He picked up a potato from nearby and threw it at the Pumpkin Giant. The potato went flying straight into the giant's mouth.
I'm sorry. I can't run, Father.
It's okay, son. I love you.
Just then, the giant fell down before them with a giant thud. Little did they know that potatoes act like a magical potion for giants, which sent him into eternal slumber.
What?
Huh?
It's a miracle.
The angels have blessed us.
Daphne ran out in haste, and seeing that her husband and son were fine, hugged them.
Oh, I'm so glad that you are safe. But what do we do about this giant in our form?
Just as she said that, the Pumpkin Giant burst into a cloud of sparkling dust, leaving behind only a bunch of seeds that had scattered around the field when the giant collapsed. The kingdom rejoiced at the wonderful news, and everyone was happy, especially King Rainer.
This is fantastic. My darling Diana, you do not need the wizards around you all the time anymore. And you are now safe to go around the kingdom.
In the midst of all his happiness and excitement, the king forgot to knight the poor farmer who was quite hurt about it. And so was Daphne. However, Aeneas did not think much about it. After the fearful encounter with the pumpkin giant, Aeneas decided that he would start becoming fitter. Eat healthy food like leafy vegetables and fruits, eggs in a proper proportion, avoid junk food. He started exercising regularly, and after a few months by the time it was spring, he had become fitter and reduced his weight. One day, as Aeneas was exercising in the potato field, he noticed vines growing across the field.
Father, that looks odd. There are vines growing everywhere.
Yes, I wonder what it is. Must be some wild plants growing. Let it be.
They ignored the vines and went about their day. The next morning when they went out into the field, they saw that it was covered in pumpkin giant heads.
Oh no! One pumpkin giant was bad for us. But now, there's an entire army.
Seeing the potato fields filled with what looked like giant heads struck fear into the hearts of the people of Colossia. But the lack of any scary faces and movement put the people at ease over time. Now, even though Aeneas had stopped eating unhealthily, he could not resist his childhood habit of having to taste almost everything and was wondering what it would taste like to have some of the pumpkin.
I'm so tempted to give the pumpkin a little taste.
Later that day, when his father had gone out for some work, Aeneas went out into the field and cut up a slice of the pumpkin and took a bite.
Ooh, this is so good!
He took bite after bite and soon gobbled up an entire pumpkin.
That was delicious. I must go and tell Mum to try it. Mother, I ate a bit of the pumpkin head. It was so tasty. You should try it.
What? You know it's not right to eat any strange things. You could fall very ill.
I know, Mother, but I couldn't help it.
Oh, my son, how could you do that? What if something happens to you?
Don't worry, I feel fine.
That evening, when Patroclus came back home, he was shocked to hear about the incident.
Oh, Father, don't be so perturbed by this. I am fine, and you should try it too. These are surely delicious.
Patroclus thought about it for a few moments, and since the pumpkin heads had sprung out instead of the potatoes, they were extremely hungry and decided to give it a try. Just then, Daphne said,
I could put it in some water and stew it for some time.
Wonderful!
They sat and ate the stewed pumpkin, and as they took the first bite, their faces lit up.
This is so good!
I did not expect this to be so yummy!
Over the next few days, Daphne decided to use her creativity and mixed some ingredients with it, such as milk, eggs, and sugar and spices, and put it in some plates lined with puff paste and kept it in the oven to bake. They had never tasted anything so exquisite in their lives. They were all thrilled. They gathered the other pumpkin heads and stored them in the cellar, and Daphne baked delicious pumpkin pies every day, which they ate happily. One day, as the king was passing by the farmer's cottage, he could smell the wonderful aroma of the pumpkin pies and stopped the carriage immediately.
Go and find out what that aroma is. It smells amazing.
When the page returned, he said,
The farmer's wife is baking the giant heads.
What? Bring one to me right now.
The page went and got one of the pies, and after tasting it, waited for a few minutes. The king was eager to taste the pie and took a bite, and immediately he was mesmerized.
This is marvelous! Call for the farmer and his family.
Patroclus was brought to the king along with his wife and son, who were quite nervous.
The pie is fantastic. I shall reward you and knight you. But first, tell me, how did you make these wonderful pies?
Patroclus narrated everything that had happened and how they got the giant heads and made the pies.
Oh, noble and brave man, I had forgotten to knight you.
The king gracefully knighted the farmer, who was ecstatic. Patroclus, Daphne, and Aeneas became important parts of the royal assembly. Aeneas especially, who had explained to the king his diet, which didn't have only potatoes, but also many fruits and vegetables, which was balanced and healthy. Soon, the king announced to everyone in the kingdom to follow a healthy, balanced diet, including his own daughter. And within some time, the obesity rate dropped. The people became more athletic, and the kingdom of Colossia was soon known as the healthiest in the world.